Buffalo has some pretty big Billy Joel fans, where under the city's famous snow clouds, they'll come out on a cold November night and fill up the local hockey arena to hear Billy Joel fill it with music. Here in Buffalo, he realizes his popularity in Philadelphia is much bigger.
I played Philly a lot in the early days. Clubs and colleges. There's a lot of colleges in Philly. And we got a great response, you know, in the early days in Philadelphia, probably because of the airplay of Captain Jack. Captain Jack will get you high tonight.
Do you look forward to Philadelphia more maybe than other cities when you come on tour?
Well, I have to admit there is a certain prejudice towards Philly because the audiences are so good. Every time we play in Philly, it's as if I'm a hometown guy and I'm not even from Pennsylvania. I'm from Long Island. And I almost feel like I'm a native son when I come back there. It's as if Philly said, okay, you're one of us. And the crowd is noisy and warm and enthusiastic. So it really is something to look forward to.
Billy Joel rewards the loyalty of his longtime fans at Philadelphia concerts by playing some older and obscure songs from his past. Songs he and his band don't play on other nights in other cities. Songs fans in other cities wouldn't know, but songs fans in this city crave to hear. Some from way back in his days playing clubs in Philadelphia.
It was my first other city that I ever went to when I was in a band. And we played in some club. It might have been even been the Beach. This is back in the late 60s, 68, 69. And you know, when I went home, I was telling people stories of my travels. Yeah, I went all the way to Philly, you know.
The relationship between Billy Joel and Philadelphia goes way back and will likely go way on.